Hello everyone, this is Big Money Chasing Big Money by Running a Grass Node. In this video, I will show you how I earned a few hundred dollars in passive income using nothing but a tiny PC and a broadband connection. Grass is definitely a really interesting project that seems to be getting quite serious. I have been using it for a few months and I will share everything I've learned so far. If you want to know what this is all about and how it works, how much you can earn with running this node, this video is for you. Let's start by clarifying what Grass is. Grass is a decentralized data scraping network that lets users delegate their internet access and earn rewards for doing so. In a nutshell, you can sell your unused bandwidth to data collectors who are in much need of up-to-date info scraped from the web. Usually, data scraping jobs were done by big corporations, but since decentralized tech solutions have emerged, the landscape has provided some new opportunities. For the first time, individual users can own the data network. It means that anyone who runs the node on their devices can earn rewards for the data that is being collected. Data collection has been quite the buzz in recent times since AI is being trained by large language models that often consists of data scraped from the web. This is how Grass makes money basically. They aggregate the data collected by the nodes of users and sell it to tech corporations who improve their AI products in return. Data collection might sound scary and concerning at first, and I was cautious in the beginning too. Reading through the technical details, however, made me realize that the node I would be running does not take control of my device, it just simply reroutes the data traffic from my IP address. The income generated by all the data scraping is then distributed to the users in the form of reward points. Reward points are converted to Grass tokens, which can be staked or sold at will. Running a node might sound too much of a technical term, but in reality, it is nothing more than an app that you can install on your device and keep it running. The device can be a PC, a Mac, a phone, or a tablet running iOS. From the Android device lineup, only Solana phones are supported for the time being. I guess it will take some more time to push it through the Play Store for Google. As I have a low energy consumption mini PC at a remote location that I use for running a trading terminal, I already had a perfect device for running the Grass node. At first, the node was a browser extension, but now it is a standard desktop application that I can turn on and off anytime. One of the great features of the app is that it really only uses the bandwidth that is not taken by any other means, so it really relies on the unused part of the connection. I have been running the node for almost 9 months now, and I have never experienced any issues with my bandwidth. My internet speed has never decreased one bit. Quite often I forgot that the node was running in the background in the first place. The requirement for a successful node operation is therefore a device that can run the application and a stable internet connection, and basically that's it. Once the node is up and running, it will generate Grass points. The rewards are based on network, which means that if you try to set up several nodes on the same home network, for example, the rewards will be shared among those nodes, so it's a smart way to avoid basically the abuse of the reward systems. The development of the Grass network is broken down to different time sections. The largest ones are called stages, which consists of smaller sections called epochs. The first stage was called building the network, which had 7 main epochs and 2 extra ones. During this time, the focus was on obtaining more and more users from all around the globe to ensure a steady flow of data from as many endpoints as possible. The stage where we are at now is called capturing the web. I think this is the part where most of the simple data scraping and optimization will happen, and where the reward system will find its ideal shape and form. When running a node, there are several things that can affect the points that are earned. The daily earning for running a node uninterrupted is 2400 points. Depending on the quality of the network and the location, there is a percentage multiplier added to this. In my location, that multiplier is 0.75, which means that I earn 75% of the full 2400 points, which makes it 1800. There is a bonus multiplier for running the desktop node, which doubles the points. This makes it 3600 points per day for a full day of activity. This means that by each month, the average maximum I can make is roughly 100k points. The question is, how many tokens will it generate for me by the end of stage 2? The calculations are always revealed at the end of each stage, so there is no sure method for a proper estimation. If they keep the 5000 to 1 conversion ratio, I think I will be quite happy. As a cherry on top, the earnings can be improved by referral bonuses. As we are rather early in the life cycle of this project, you get rewarded generously for inviting new members. If your invitees invite others, you will also get a fraction of the onboarding bonuses. At first, I was not very happy about this model, but as the point is crowd enlargement, which is quite successful, I am really in no position to criticize the approach. There are certain milestones. As you collect the points, you can basically level up as you keep the node running. Hitting each milestone will grant further bonus points as per the following. There is Iron, Bronze, Silver, Gold, Platinum, Emerald, Diamond, Conqueror, Vanguard, and Titan tiers. It is clear that those node operators who can maintain a decent uptime and provide a reliable access to their unused bandwidth are rewarded quite well. Once you reach Vanguard tier, you get basically a month's worth of bonus points. These bonuses can also be achieved by successful new member invitations, so if you have a community where you can share your invitation code, you can obtain these bonuses even without running a node for too long. Now, let's see the tokenomics. After all, conversion rates from points to tokens don't matter too much if the value of the tokens is low as a rugged meme coin. Therefore, it is important to understand how Grass would maintain the value of its tokens. I was pleasantly surprised to see that after the token generation event, or TGE, the price did not plummet. I was expecting a lot of selling pressure from users who were waiting for a huge payout but were disappointed for some reason in the end. Even if selling pressure was big, it was great to see that Grass had a coordinated launch or major exchanges, meaning that a lot of buying pressure hit the markets at the same time. Timing was also quite fortunate, as it was in the middle of a heavy bullish momentum, so the bulls eventually took control and pushed the price up to almost $4 per token. Today, it has retraced a little bit, but looking at the market cap, it is reassuring to see that there were no big market dumps right after the TGE. Staking is probably the other reason why the selling was weaker than anticipated. Currently, staking Grass tokens will have almost a 50% APR, which means that if you stake 100 tokens today, in a year's time, you will get 150 back. You can also apply some compounding, which will make it even more. The other very important aspect of Grass tokenomics is that the investor allocations are vested and will be released gradually after the lockup period ends. Furthermore, the vested tokens cannot be staked, so users have an advantage for staking. It will be interesting to see how the conversion rates will evolve for the next airdrops. If we get anywhere near close to the 5,000-to-1 ratio and keep the price that we have today, I will have no reasons to complain. With a bit of luck, price will keep on rising and users will have the benefit of making some decent gains on their service. Alright guys, this was my short introduction to Grass. I believe I managed to cover everything that is worth knowing before jumping into this. I am happy the way things are progressing with this project. I mean, it has already paid for my internet subscription costs, so you know, I'm already in profit basically. If you have some unused bandwidth at home and you can run a node, why not turn some of the idle capacity into tokens that you can stake or sell? I have included the invitation link in the description field, so feel free to use that for registrations if you are interested. I will keep an eye out for the price action to see how it evolves. With a bit of luck, it will keep on rising in the coming months as the network gains strength and momentum keeps on going. Soon, I will be uploading some more videos about interesting projects, and I have something huge coming from January 1st. Until then, stay safe. Big money out.